Having a mare. Mare. Her mare.
I'm Darrell Peck. Join me on a journey as I tackle some of the UK's finest carp fisheries.
That was epic, wasn't it?
Witness my extreme highs.
Yeah, boy.
Followed by some devastating lows.
Should have caught one last night.
Living and breathing all things carp.
There's a little white dinner plate down there, and they're coming for it.
It is literally like the North Sea out there.
Staying mobile.
Now we're cooking.
And always searching for the next opportunity.
What a day.
Doing all I can to get that next bite.
Now I'll make the rear.
We're here for one thing. The Big Carp Buzz.
To protect us against the risk of as yet unidentified new strains,
we will also temporarily close all travel corridors from 0400.
My gosh, it's bloody nice round here.
Previously on the Big Carp Buzz, we talked about filming at a huge reservoir in France, but unfortunately, COVID has put pay to that, and we are restricted to filming in the UK. On the flip side though, we have managed to get permission to film on the Wasing Estates Oxlease Lake. It's a 10 acre lake roughly, with 75 to 80 really old, really nice English carp, and there is said to be maybe three different 50 pounders in there. It's now the end of September. It's the perfect time to be targeting the slightly deeper venues, and I am really, really excited to get started. So without further ado, let's do this. We've arrived at 5 o'clock in the evening. We've driven around the perimeter of the lake just to see how you get in, how you access each bank, etc. And from this point forward, I'm gonna have a little walk around, check the swims out, see sort of what swim fishes, what area, sort of get my eye in so that I can pick a position. So tomorrow at first light, I don't wanna be walking, I wanna be stood looking, trying to see something. And the best way to do that is to get, I need to have an idea of where the best vantage points are to see the most water. At the far end, as I'm looking this way, there's what you'd sort of say, it's almost like a dam wall. You've got two end pegs and then sort of a no fishing bank that separates this lake from Cranwell. So there's actually two anglers fishing. Both of them typically, you know, are in the dam wall swims, as you'd call them, like the end pegs that fish along that end of the lake. The wind's blowing that way, so maybe they're just there because the wind's blowing in that direction. You know, I know absolutely nothing. I couldn't tell you if it's 25 foot out there or 2 foot deep. I know nothing. But over the course of these days, you know, hopefully I'm going to track these fish down and get myself in a position where I feel like I'm going to catch one. But at the moment, I know nothing. It'll be a real steep learning curve, you know, as the information starts to come in, as I start to find some fish. But yeah, I'm excited, you know, when there's three fish around 50 pounds in here, you know, if you get a few bites, you never know what can happen. Start with, you know, to start with, one bite. That's all we need, one bite to start with, because it isn't going to be easy. But yeah, probably said enough now, let's go for a look. Oh, I feel really tired now.
My missus has a good chicken noise. There's a lot of bubbling going on here.
Thank you. what a difference a night's sleep can make. You know, yesterday, arrived sort of early evening, quick trot about, and it looked sort of desolate, nothing going on. You know, just we were just too late for the sun and nothing really jumped out. Slept, didn't see anything at first light where I was sort of camped for the night. Went down to the far end, saw a small common jump out, and then one of the cameramen has called me to say that the guy in the next peg to where we camped has caught a 35 pounder, and it was an epic carp. We're talking purple in colour, covered in petal-like scales. It was a lovely fish. And in the time that we were photographing it, at least 10 fish have showed in the last few hours, all in a sort of a real localised area. Not where he caught from, but in front of that swim. But that is a sure sign that I want to have a rig there tonight. So the guy who's caught one, he's off in about half an hour. And that's just going to leave us on the whole lake. You know, the whole lake is devoid of anglers, but I'm feeling quietly confident. You know, anything can change. The wind is due to blow down there tomorrow, so I might wake up tomorrow morning to the disturbance I've made has scared them off. But first morning on the lake to see that level of activity, yeah, I'm excited.
Oh, it's fizzy out there.
Oh my God, look at that! Look at that, quick, get it!
The bit on the right?
Oh, get it! You got that? Woo woo!
I'm excited now.
Oh yeah, and again!
After being in the swim and seeing so many fish, my excitement clearly got the better of me. The original plan went right out the window, and I decided the best thing that I could do was get a rig right amongst them, and quick.
A lovely blue Peter, freshly sharpened.
Starting point, this was more than I could have hoped for. Finding the fish and having a rig in the area, and I'm in with a chance here. Time passed without the bite that I'd hoped for, and to be honest, I was probably asking too much of the lake too soon. In the meantime, I'd managed to sharpen plenty of hooks in preparation for the days ahead. As they say, failure to prepare is preparing to fail, and that I was not willing to do. In the time that I'd spent preparing these hooks, the morning period had drifted away. I realised I could be doing this much better by fishing the swim opposite. The fish were actually closer to that side, and there was another spot under the trees where I could place a rig as well. A quick move and I was back in the game. At least this way I could get my traps in and set ready for the following morning in hope that they would return. When I got round there, I set to work placing both rods in likely looking areas. The first rod was positioned on an overhanging tree along the causeway bank with just a handful of bait around it. Before I had left the other swim, I had fired the marker float out to the area where I'd seen the fish, so now that I was on the opposite bank, I could take the bait boat out and drop the rig on the tiniest of clear spots amongst the weed. That was it, the traps were set. It was down to the fish to make the next move.
Thank you. So we've had the rods out for one night and the fish were here yesterday in quite good numbers. And I was quite confident, but in the back of my mind as well, I did know that it was sort of, the wind is due to change and today it's blowing at the other end. The activity out here has massively reduced. You know, there was loads of showing going on out here yesterday, quite a lot of bubbling. And there has been one fish out here this morning, one definite one, a little bit of bubbling, one other show that I didn't exactly see, but not the same level of activity, you know. And with that in my mind, I'm looking at the weather on my phone and it was 24 yesterday, it's 23 today, but it's dropping, you know, 17 degrees tomorrow, 14 degrees the day after, 14 degrees the day after and 13 after that. So it is really gonna drop. Couple that with a brisk southwesterly and it is gonna feel really, really cool, you know. And I've got a feeling I was a day too late here, 24 hours too late. If I'd have been in this position 24 hours earlier, I think I'd have had a really good chance. But yeah, I think I'm just behind where I need to be, really. And that is just purely based on instinct and not on anything else. You know, I don't know the lake, I don't know the spots. You know, this wind could change and all the fish could still end up here tomorrow morning. But I just got a feeling about the other end. I saw a fish down there on the first morning. And yeah, with the wind pushing down there, it'll be pushing into that bowl, but it's also got quite a bit of sheltered water there. So they can get out of the wind if it's freezing cold. But I'm gonna go with my instinct. I'm gonna move down there. We've still got three, maybe four nights to go. So it's a difficult lake. It's not gonna be easy, but we're just getting into it. I'm just getting a feel for it.
With the midday sun creeping in and no signs of fish in the area, I decided to go with my gut feeling. I began packing away and making my way down to the swim at the other end of the lake. I suspect they'll be making their way down to this area as the weather turns, so being able to get everything set and ready for the morning means hopefully I'll be one step ahead of them. I started by casting a bare lead to the area where I'd seen the fish jump on the day that I arrived. I managed to find a lovely spot here. It was just a couple of rod lengths back from the snags, pure gravel, and it absolutely screamed carp.
Right, well that's the spot. I'm gonna go around and put the old tigers out there with a catty. I'm not sure about all this. It's not looking right. No, mate, we've gone the wrong way. I don't know if we can get to it. Oh, I'm itchy. There's something in the trees that's itchy. Why can't I get to that float? Why can't I see it? There's no way of getting there, man.
Spot now baited, I made my way back around, but I was suddenly having second thoughts.
Really torn what to do, you know. Saw one fish in this bay when I arrived yesterday. But I've come down here on the strength that the wind's blowing down here and it doesn't really hit this bit of the lake, it just looks a bit, I don't know, just a little bit, there's a little scum on the water. And I've only managed to find one nice spot. I'm quite happy with it, you know, one rod. But just on the other side of this bank of trees, the wind's hammering down the lake and it just looks carpy as hell. But I haven't seen fish there and I've seen a fish here, so it's a real tough one. I've made the decision. I don't know if it's the right one. I haven't seen any fish, but it just doesn't feel right in here.
My mind was made up. I was on the move again to the central body of the lake. The thinking here was that I'd be well placed to intercept them on the way to the deep bowl. This way, I had two flips of the coin. If I failed here, I could fall back on my baited area in the bowl.
I'm moving into a swim that I've seen nothing in. Thank you. feels good. Feels good.
We're good.
Is the float sunk? The float's gone under. And that's there. Oh, that looks really nice, that does. That looks really nice. There's a passing point. That's on it. It is literally like the f***ing North Sea out there. That's it.
Full Terry.
Lovely firm drop. Right, other rod. That is out of hand. Properly out of hand, that is. I'm confident that if I can find some fish, I will catch one. Whether that'll be tonight, I'm not too confident, but we'll have to wait and see.
Heard a fish off to my right in the bowl, and this was a sure sign that I'd made a massive mistake yesterday. I needed to get my stuff together as quickly as possible and get back to the original plan.
Come on, rush.
All of the clues from the last couple of days had pointed in this direction. I really should have gone with my gut. Having meticulously plumbed that gravel spot yesterday, all I had to do was wrap up, cast out, hit the clip, get the mega drop, and then I was fishing.
Oh, we need to turn that down. Jesus.
That's one rod on the money. Let's get another out there.
Oh, for f***'s sake.
To take.
Keep out of the way.
Immediate danger thwarted. We're good.
Ben, you come and just reel this rod in the margin for us.
Go on, quick. Have that one in. Just in the edge somewhere. Sorry, I thought it might be further out than that. Right, we're good.
well, not been round here long, the spot that I'd baited yesterday, just before we moved, cast a single on it, and then just on the way back from baiting the second rod, just put a few pouchfuls of tigers over the top. Just a little, just three or four pouchfuls, just to freshen it up a bit, and it's gone straight away. That is a good sign. It's all good. God, let's try getting reeds. It's a nice scaly one. By the looks of it, it's a good fish, that is. Rolling it on the line. That is a nice fish. Not a monster, but a nice one. Here we go. Here we go. Why though? Don't do it. Go on, go in there. Go on, go on, go on, go on, go on.
That's bigger than you think. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Oh, that is a proper carp, that is. That is a proper carp. Oh, I'm happy with that. That is nice. That's a nice old carp, that is. Ah. Finally, finally, 36 pounds of Oxlease mirror. What a buzz, you know. A couple of nights in, really, really concerned that we weren't gonna catch. And the pressure was really, really on. But fortunately, I saw that fish and a quick reaction onto yesterday's baited spot and big, big result. Conditions out there are absolutely mega, you know. It looks good for another one, but you know, you can never count your chickens on lakes like this. It's a proper venue, really, really difficult. And you've got to be ultra grateful for the ones that you do catch. And I am very, very grateful.
Get across how different it feels to have caught one to have not caught one, you know, to be going into, say, the third night having not caught. I would be really, really stressed at this point, you know. There's a lot of pressure on the line when it's just me, you know. It's different when I'm on Thinking Tackle Masterclass. It's not just one guy, you know. This is just me on my own, and if I don't catch, then there is no film. And after a couple of blank nights, you do start to feel it. And seeing that fish, getting round here, getting in the swim, getting the rod out there, good drop, catch the fish, you know, it just reinforces everything that you know about carp fishing. You know, when you get it right, you align the dots, you get on the right spot, get on the fish, get the presentation correct, then you catch them, you know. And that, when you get that confidence, you know you can do it again, you know. I'm looking at, oh, a lot of fish in my swim at this point, you know. I've recast. I've seen countless fish top, pretty much over the rig, some left, some right, some short, some further. But they are here, there's quite a few carp in this area. I've got a really good drop on the recast, and I am already questioning why I've not had another one. But, you know, I'm happy, you know, I'm over the moon with what I've already caught, but there's some really big and some really special carp in this lake. So I'm on the edge of my seat a little bit, and I'm very, intrigued for what the night will bring. There's a lot of doubt going on with that many fish topping and nothing happening. And I was questioning it, but we're in. Feels like a good fish. Oh, back into the line. It's deep out here. Oh, come on. When there's so many big fish in here, you are questioning what it is. That feels like a good fish. Done me a favour going left. There's a good chance this will go through the other line. Not a lot I can do about it, really. Oh, fish just jumped out down there. Did you hear that? Is it right? Well, hang on 1 second. Let me just grab the net and bring it to this side. There's a good fish. It's a common. Here we go. Come on. Come on. Whee! Yes! Get in there. Yes! Yes! That looks like another 30. Oh. Oh man, that's quite fat. Wide that is. Oh, check that out. They were showing over me all afternoon, you know. And I'm starting to doubt, is it tangled? Is it sat right? But the line was good, the drop was good, and kept the confidence. A little bit more bait, and 1 hour into dark, this is the result. 37 pounds of Oxlease common, and you never know, you know, the conditions are amazing. The fish are here, and there's every chance of another one yet. Why do they always want to go left? Cue the liner.
And cue more fish. Clearly, I was in the right place at the right time, and it wasn't long before I was doing battle again. Duh, for f**k's sake. We've all done this before, right?
They're webbed.
They're webbed.
After a short fight, I slid the net under another Oxlease common.
Mush. Yes.
And a little while later, I was back out for a third time, coaxing a real nice scaly character over the net.
So literally 10 minutes ago, the rod that done the first two bites went. That's in the landing net, it's a small common. I was literally just re-rigging the rod to put a fresh hook on. And the right hand rod's just pulled up. This one feels heavier than that one. This feels like a good fish. Good fish. This is the best time of the day to catch carp. This rod's been out there all day yesterday and then all night. And I did have a slight bit of paranoia that the first carp that I caught swam through the line as I let it go. I didn't think it moved it, but it was definitely in my mind.
Yes. Yes. That's another nice one.
It had been an incredibly productive night. I couldn't wait for the morning to break so I could take a proper look at my prize.
How's about that for a seriously cool carp? 34.5 pounds, came as part of almost a double take at first light. First the long rod went with a small common, and then the right hand rod with this, like I say, 34 pounds. Lovely apple sized scales across its back, you know. These Oxlease carp are really, really nice. I've recast, two or three fish have shown out the back over the long rod, and it looks really good for another one. But you can never count your chickens. These like three bigger ones that I've caught, you know, I'm absolutely over the moon. You know, things were bleak to start with, really, really sort of worried that we weren't going to get a film, and then the quick move and 3:30s, you just cannot grumble at that. Oh, lovely.
Oh, done. He wants to go, let's let him go. Wait for the liner, the token liner every time. We're good.
As for me small common, well, he was one slippery old customer. Having been a carp angler for over 25 years, you'd have thought I'd known how to juggle a little carp like this. Somehow, he managed to make a swift escape through my legs, but you saw him in the net and you saw him briefly, so it definitely counts.
Wide take. Well, no sooner had put that 34 pounder back, clouds come over, sort of taking the sun away. A little bit of mist coming off the lake and it's gone. The long rod again. Definitely a productive spot there. That was the first spot that I found. I could have wondered what would have happened if we'd been on that a little bit earlier.
Really deep out here, you can see by the way the line's pointing straight down. It's getting close to the other line now, which isn't good. It's going to go through it here.
Feels like a good one.
Well, that is plodding up in everyone. God, that must have been deep.
I don't think it is a big one, just the way it was deep down like that, it felt huge.
I think it is.
Just be careful of my other line. It's common, is it? This is turning into a red letter session. Continues. 28 pounds, 12 ounces, and there's still quite a few fish topping out there. A lot of bubbling going on, and it looks really good for another one. Lovely.
Regular action seemingly on the cards, I wasted no time in getting the rod back out into the zone.
That's it.
Well, that's everything refreshed. Reset. I think there's still fish about. Time for a turbo coffee. Good days. Well, today has been pretty hectic. You know, we've got it right. This afternoon, the left-hand rod, the third rod, I'm going to get that out. I'm going to have, I did see round to the left in the dark last night, two fish sort of topped, nowhere near where any of my other rods are. And I'm going to get the bait boat out this afternoon, put the third rod in there, drive it out on the echo sounder, just try and keep the disturbance to an absolute minimum. Find a depth in clear water as near to where those fish were as possible and just do a dump and run as such. But I don't know how confident to be. You know, obviously catching five fish in such a short period is great. There was loads of fish in here yesterday afternoon, and that's how you catch fish. You know, if you're on them like that, you can have mega results. But it has quietened down, and quite often, you know, in that situation when you've caught a few, they can just scoot out of this bay as quick as anything. So I'm not sure whether to be confident or not really, but like I say, there was a little bit of fizzing just around lunchtime and another one did jump out of the back. So there's every chance there's still a few fish in this bay. And what's to say with the wind coming down here that more fish might suddenly arrive, ones that haven't already been in here recently. So yeah, I don't want to count my chickens, but I don't want to sort of switch off either, because I've had a mega result, but there are some really, really, really special fish in here, and you never know what that next bite might bring. And I'm sitting here knowing that I'm fishing good spots for the sort of first time, and if those fish come into this bay and they're in the mood, then I'm fishing well. So we'll have to just have to wait and see what happens.
During the late morning period, I decided to have a nap to give the main spot as much chance as possible to producing another bite. It looked good, but nothing materialised, and in the end, the weather looked like it was about to turn, so I decided to take the bait boat out and drop the third rod where I'd seen some fish showing in the night.
13, 14, 15, it's clear. Yeah, that looks clear. I'm going to drop it there. 3, 2, 1. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Really nice.
Going into the final night, I had a feeling that the fish had done the off. Much to my surprise, in the early hours of the morning, the left-hand rod absolutely ripped.
Left-hand rod, one across to the reeds, bait boat, absolutely bust off. Can't see the line.
Yes.
Well, it looks to be low, an upper 20. It's 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm sticking him in the retention sling. It'll be light in an hour.
That's it, that's good. Excalibur.
Check that out, 29 pounds and 14 ounces of wazing common carp. The last fish, one of six, would you believe it? At the start of the session, it looked really, really bleak. We were struggling, had a couple of blank nights, but just kept persevering, kept looking for them, kept moving, and eventually found a good pod of fish in the end of a bay and got on the right spots. Six fish, no, 37 common, 36 mirror, a 34 mirror, this one, a 28, and a smaller one. So yeah, incredible, incredible fishing, and a lovely, lovely end to the Big Carp Buzz. Gone, gone, woo, woo, woo. You're recording, I know you are. I can see it's red. I can see it. And you think I didn't know. I could see it in your face.